Hello students, today we are going to discuss polynomial chapter 2, exercise 2.4, question number 1 to question number 3 of class 9. The first question is, determine which of the following polynomials has x plus 1 as a factor. The first question is x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Here we will take the x plus 1 equal to 0, then find x equal to minus 1. From this we will get the value of minus 1, then we will assign this minus 1 into this polynomial x cube plus x square plus x plus 1, that is p of minus 1 equal to minus 1 whole cube plus minus 1 whole square plus minus 1 plus 1. Then we will get 0. If you are getting 0, then we can say x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Here we are getting 0, so we can say x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. The second question is x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Here also the value of x equal to minus 1. We are assigning the same value into the second question. Minus 1 whole raised to 4 plus minus 1 whole cube plus minus 1 whole square plus minus 1 plus 1. Then 1 plus negative 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1. Here we are getting the value. This is 0. Okay, 0 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1. This is also 0. So 0 plus 0 plus 1. Here we are getting the value 1. This is not equal to 0. So x plus 1 is not a factor of this polynomial. The third question is p of x equal to x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 3x square plus x plus 1. Here also we have the value of x as minus 1, that is x equal to minus 1. And we are assigning this minus 1 to this polynomial. Okay, minus 1 whole raised to 4 plus minus 1 whole cube plus 3 into minus 1 whole square plus minus 1 plus 1. Then this is 1, then this is minus 1, so minus 3 plus 3 minus 1 plus 1. Here we are getting a 1. This is not equal to 0. So x plus 1 is not a factor of this polynomial. Fourth question is p of x equal to x cube minus x square minus 2 plus root 2 x plus root 2. X cube minus x square minus 2 plus root 2 into x plus root 2. We know the value of x equal to minus 1. So p of minus 1 equal to minus 1 whole cube minus 1 whole square minus 2 plus root 2 into minus 1 plus root 2. Okay, then minus 1 into minus 1, minus 1 whole cube means minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1, that is this will become 1, positive 1. Then 1 into minus 1 becomes minus 1. So this is minus 1 minus minus 1 into minus 1, that is 1. So this is 1. Then minus 2 plus root 2 into minus 1 plus root 2. Okay. Means minus 2 minus this 2 and this minus 1, that is 2 into minus 1. That is just multiplying this 2 plus root 2 with this minus 1. So minus 2, then plus root 2 into minus 1 means minus root 2. Okay. Then minus, this is opening, the bracket is opening here. So minus and this minus will get 2. That is, this minus and minus becomes plus 2. And this minus and minus becomes plus root 2 plus root 2. Okay. And this becomes 0. Then 2 root 2. We are getting 2 root 2, which is not equal to 0. So this is not a factor of x cube minus x square minus 2 plus root 2 into x. Okay. Second question is, use the factor theorem to determine whether g of x is a factor of p of x in each of the following cases. P of x equal to 2x cube plus x square minus 2x minus 1, then g of x equal to x plus 1. In this question, p of x equal to this one and g of x equal to x plus 1. So, we are taking the value of x from this g of x, that is x plus 1 equal to 0. We are assigning 0, x plus 1 equal to 0, so x equal to minus 1. Then, we are giving this minus 1 into this polynomial. So, 2 into minus 1 whole cube plus minus 1 whole square plus, minus 2 into minus 1 minus 1. So, 2 into minus 1 whole cube means minus 1. Then, this is plus 1. Then, this minus and this minus becomes plus. So, plus 2 minus 1. Then, this is minus 2. Then, plus 1 plus 2 minus 1 equal to 0. Then, this plus 2 and minus 2 and plus 2 get cancelled, then plus 1 and minus 1 get cancelled, so becomes 0. So we are getting a 0. So g of x is a factor of p of x. We are getting a 0. That's why we are writing g of x is a factor of p of x. Then we have p of x, second question, x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1 and g of x equal to x plus 2. Here x equal to minus 2, because x plus 2 equal to 0, from this we are getting the value x equal to minus 2. Just substituting that minus 2 into this polynomial, minus 2 whole cube plus 3 into minus 2 whole square plus 3 into minus 2 plus 1. Then minus 2 whole cube means minus 8. Then minus 2 whole square means that is 4. 4 into 3, that is 12. Then minus 6 plus 1. Then we are getting minus 14 plus 13 equal to minus 1. Okay, so this is also not equal to 0. So g of x is not a factor of p of x. If you are getting a 0 here, then we can say g of x is a factor of p of x. And third is, we have x cube minus 4x square plus 6 plus 6 and g of x equal to x minus 3. So x is 3 here. So we are assigning, substituting this 3 to this polynomial, 3 cube minus 4 into 3 square plus 3 plus 6. Okay, this is 27. Then minus 4 into 9 plus 3 plus 6. And 27 minus 9 into 4, 36 plus 3 plus 6 equal to 0. Then we are getting the value 0 here. So g of x is a factor of p of x. The third question is, find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of p of x in each of the following cases. Here x minus 1. So we have to find the x from this x minus 1. So x becomes 1. Here x minus 1 is a factor. So x equal to 1. Then assigning this 1 to this polynomial, 1 square plus 1 plus k, that is 1 plus 1 plus k equal to 0. 2 plus k equal to 0, k equal to minus 2. Okay, then second question, p of x equal to 2x square plus kx plus root 2. Here also x equal to 1. So 2 into 1 square plus k into 1 plus root 2. So 2 plus k plus root 2 equal to 0. So k equal to minus 2 minus root 2. We can take minus as a common value, so 2 plus root 2. So k value is minus 2 plus root 2. The third question is, p of x equal to kx square minus root 2x plus 1. Here the x value is 1, because the factor is x minus 1. We are getting the x as 1. So p of 1 equal to k into 1 square minus root 2 into 1 plus 1. So k minus root 2 plus 1 equal to 0. So k equal to, this minus will go to right side, so it becomes plus, and this plus will go to right side, this becomes minus. So root 2 minus 1. Fourth question is, p of x equal to kx square minus 3x plus k. Here we are assigning x equal to 1. So k into 1 square minus 3 into 1 plus k. So k minus 3 plus k equal to 0. So k plus k equal to 2k minus 3 equal to 0. Then 2k equal to 3. This minus will go to right side. It becomes minus becomes plus. So k equal to this 2 will go to right side. Here this is multiplication. It will go to the right side and becomes division. So 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is the answer.